Most of the injured were brought to St Thomas's Hospital. They'd expected only 20, but it soon became clear many more had been hurt. With 40 others taken to St Stephen's in Chelsea, the final tally was over 100. Most were suffering from whiplash injuries, cuts, sprains and bruises, though there were some broken bones. All looked dazed and shocked. They included many American tourists, like this man from Atlanta, just beginning his first trip to the UK.
Well, there were several people thrown around. There was a lady that had trouble breathing, and there was a couple of seats that were broken down. And people were mostly nosebleeds and things of this nature.
Are you able to go on with your holiday?
I hope so.
It must be terrible, your first trip to the UK and this happens. How do you feel?
Pretty tough greeting.
A group of 8 scouts from Wallingham in Surrey were also caught in the collision. One broke a leg, but those not injured helped other passengers.
People beside me, they were bleeding everywhere. There were 3 seats. We were 2 seats.
Were you able to help any of them, or were you too shocked?
We had some plasters, first aid kits. We got them out and started to bandage people up.
By lunchtime, most of the injured were able to leave hospital.
Because their injuries didn't give overwhelming cause for concern, we've been able to cope, and we've had a great sufficiency of staff, excellent response from the hospital staff, and of course the staff within the department have coped magnificently.
Tonight, a handful of passengers are being detained in both hospitals, but none is giving cause for concern. John Andrew at St Thomas's.